I worshiping here in front of President Palace because GKI Yasmin in Bogor cannot service every Sunday actually.
The GKI Yasmin Church has been meeting outside the Presidential Palace in Jakarta since 2012. This month, it will hold its 100th worship service on the street. Its building in Bogor City, on Jakarta's suburbs, remains sealed in defiance of a Supreme Court order. The mayor of Bogor is under pressure from Islamist groups to restrict the congregation from using their own place of worship.
It's very hard to be minority in Indonesia, and we have to fight for our rights. It's not easy, but it will not affect my faith.
While they are holding on to their faith in God, church members are now beginning to lose their confidence in the ability of President Jokowi, who will complete 1 year in office in October.
Saya pikir hal-hal seperti ini tetap terjadi karena ketidakberanian atau sikap tegas yang tidak ada dari seorang presiden. Seharusnya pemimpin negeri ini berani untuk melakukan sebuah terobosan, bertindak untuk menegakkan hukum yang ada. Karena ini sebenarnya tidak boleh dibiarkan begitu saja. Persoalan-persoalan yang terjadi sebenarnya untuk kepentingan orang banyak dan demi kemajuan kedamaian yang ada di Indonesia.
President Jokowi was expected not to repeat the mistakes of his predecessor, Susilo Yudhoyono, who was criticized for being indecisive and weak before Islamist extremists. Jokowi appears to have the will to enforce the court order, but he hasn't been able to act due to political issues. Andreas Harsono, a political analyst who works with Human Rights Watch, explained why.
His ruling coalition was not a majority in the parliament. He himself was not fully supported by his own party, PDIP. But he need to consolidate his coalition in the parliament. And he only did that last week when he got the majority in the parliament.
Even the local situation in Bogor City hasn't improved.
The mayor, who I think the key person who can decide what will be in Bogor, still has people around him who is still intolerant.
Andreas Harsono said the GKI Yasmin Church is only one of the numerous churches whose religious freedom is being violated.
According to the communions of churches in Indonesia, there are nearly 1,000 churches closed down, some even burned, during the Yudhoyono administration. Legally, they are sealed, but the congregations use either back door or quietly use the church, you know, without bringing cars, without crowding the parking spaces.
Christians acknowledge that President Jokowi has brought at least some changes in the religious atmosphere of the country. For example, extremist groups, including the Islamic Defenders Fund, locally known as FPI, and another such group, Garis, now appear to be less active.
Garis is the organization who the protests us, and the leader has already in jail, and the protests to us is getting lower and lower.
The GKI Yasmin Church says it will continue to hold as many worship services on the street as it takes to regain their right to use their church building.
Pertanyaan seringkali datang kepada kami, harus sampai kapan kami seperti ini? Menurut kami, perjuangan ini harus terus dilakukan. Sampai kapan? Sampai pemerintah berani melakukan sesuatu demi keadilan, demi perjuangan kami. Memang rasa letih seringkali menghampiri kami. Harapan kami seolah-olah memudar. Tapi kami diingatkan bahwa umat percaya, orang yang berharap kepada Tuhan, tidak boleh menyerah di dalam perjuangan. Kami akan terus berjuang, karena sebenarnya perjuangan yang kami lakukan bukan untuk hak-hak kami saja, tetapi juga untuk orang lain, untuk terciptanya bangsa Indonesia, negeri Indonesia yang kami cintai menjadi negeri kedamaian.